Hello people, welcome back to another episode of our movie preview and review. Is your favorite girl B. Today I'll be reviewing this amazing six-part series that dropped on Netflix from Nollywood or Lola Day. Come along with me, guys.
Alaba, are you new Lossy Waju? Udise, you see promotion. Legal, you only can see what you need.
Ololade is a six-part series and it follows the story of two friends who suddenly became rich. I don't have a lot to say about Ololade. There's really nothing much to say about it. It was a mess. What worked? Nothing. Some series or movies start well, then things scatter in the middle. You see the potential right from the start and can't help but acknowledge that it could have been great, if not for some flaws. But this particular movie is an entirely different conversation. It was bad from start to finish. What were the issues? Acting and casting did not work. Very random and ineffective casting. No outstanding performances, no likable characters, no shining moments. You look at some of the characters and you just wonder, why is this person here? As if the whole thing was not tiring enough, they gave Mide Martins the role of a gentlewoman. Who does that? I kept on repeating, Mide, this is not you. Nobody delivered in this series, not even the GOAT. I won't talk about how cringe all Mr. Macaroni's scenes were, or the fact that this Twitter influencer, Ole Ekun, had no business being in this series, or the fact that the band they hired to sing at the housewarming party could not sing. But one thing I will say is that Bosse was the most annoying character in this movie. That babe cannot act to save her life. Another issue I had with this movie, the series, was the fact that the story itself, the way it was told, the way everything progressed, did not make any sense. What was the series about? Money rituals or money laundering? I had so many questions. What was that bank scene? A man wearing a bada walked into the bank. He ought to panic and disappeared. Who was he? A real person or a ghost? We were all waiting to see where Shina's money actually came from. Imagine my shock when I heard Ihotu's explanation. They were hiding from the government. How did Ihotu know Shina's account number and name? She disappeared before he even finished his transaction. If Ihotu and her Black Lion people are so powerful and rich, what did they mean by the government was after them because of 50 million naira? What did she mean by they had to kill all the government people after them? Everything about Ihotu's character was just off. Her fox fierce look, her oversized jacket, the first mystery around her, the Black Lions and their money, everything did not make sense. Plot progression was not good. There were too many unnecessary scenes. Everything was just dragging. Ololade had no business being a series. They did not say or do anything that deserves more than 90 minutes screen time. I did not like the setting. I did not like the set pieces. For example, the shrine looked like something that was hurriedly assembled by a church drama team, because what was that white hair in the background? Or the office chair they wrapped with red clothes? I thought the whole thing was a prank to scare Shina, but later realized it was actually real. For a series that is about 50 million naira, why exactly did they have dollars as the closing montage of each episode? What was the purpose? Or it just felt nice? What was the central theme of this series? For a series that claimed to be a homage to Nollywood classics, nothing resonated. Did you notice that the bank gave a customer without any credit history a loan of 18 million naira in 2 days? Did you notice that after Latif exhumed Laide's corpse, her eyes were still open, looking clear and healthy? These tiny errors were everywhere in this series, so I was not disappointed with the way the final episode unfolded. It was a befitting end for a series where nothing worked. What I did not understand, however, is the fact that they had the audacity, the temerity, the effrontery to hint at a season 2. Or did they not? Ololade should have been uploaded on YouTube. It felt like a poorly made skit without a hint of wit, coherence, style, or originality. Overall, this was not a good watch, and it is impossible for me to recommend it on any level. Poor scripts, poor casting, and poor acting. Weak and incoherent plot progression, and of course, poor conclusion. A Netflix original. Ololade is another puzzling addition to the Netflix Nolliverse. Plenty money and effort, but little thought. This makes me wonder if there's indeed a secret cabal duping Netflix into selecting woefully deficient scripts because what was this scene?
You, I know you.
Owo mi da.
Iti ku o ti pa yan. Kini won to do? Ye, she no. Ah! I want to go ni baba sale.
And with that, guys, I'll be rating this movie a 0.5 out of a 10. I'm trying to be so nice not to give them a total zero. So I'll be giving them a 0.5 out of 10. Have you seen this movie? What are your thoughts about this movie? Let me know in the comment section. If you're yet to see the movie, please go do so at your own risk and come tell me what you think about the movie, if you agree with me or not. Don't also forget to like, share, and comment. I remain your favorite girl, B. And please don't forget to follow us on our social media handles. On Instagram, we'll go by e.com_official. For Facebook and YouTube, we'll go by e.com official. And for Twitter, we'll go by edotcom01, all in lowercase alphabet. Bye, guys. Have an amazing weekend.